Look here. These mini split air conditioner circuit boards are placed here. This is just to set your mindset at the start of the video so that you can understand well what I'm going to explain next. As you might have seen in the thumbnail, why are there two IPMs, intelligent power modules, on the mini split air conditioner circuit board? I will explain to you where this technology came from. Companies are still manufacturing the older models of inverter air conditioner circuit boards. There's not much of an issue with them, but what's the deal with having two IPMs on this circuit board? I will give you a detailed explanation of that. To help you understand, I am showing you this circuit board that uses a single IPM. These single IPM circuit boards are perfect and work efficiently. However, many companies are using two IPMs on their circuit boards. Apart from that, this PCB is also perfect. This model's circuit is perfect too. So what's the purpose of using two IPMs on this circuit board, and what do they achieve? I will answer these questions for you. This dual IPM circuit board is installed in the outdoor unit of Samsung inverter mini split air conditioners. It is found in some Samsung models, but LG uses these two IPMs on their circuit boards on a much larger scale. Almost every LG model has dual IPMs. You can see that this circuit board also has two IPMs installed. This particular one is from a 2-ton unit, this PCB is from a 1-ton unit, and this one is from a 1.5-ton Samsung unit. Now let me clarify who first developed this double IPM technology in circuit boards. It was created by Fairchild, a company that conducts research on electronic components. They were the first to innovate this technology. Now, let me explain these two IPMs to you. First, let's talk about the left side IPM. This left side IPM is responsible for driving the compressor. Its job is to generate the frequency and voltages for the compressor and then drive it. In LG circuit boards, the left side IPM also serves the same function. I have removed the module from the other side. Now, this module is designed similarly to an IPM, but it's not an IPM. Instead, the company has named it a smart power module for partial switching converter, or you could also call it a smart power module for single phase boost for PFC. This means that this module boosts the PFC, power factor correction. Why is there a need to boost the PFC when we already see that in other units, a system for PFC correction is already present, and it's also present in this unit? So what's the need for it? Now I'll tell you why it's necessary. The reason is that the PFC is corrected to clean up the current so that any non-active current is removed and only active current is used. Normally, the non-active current isn't completely removed by the PFC system. To remove it completely, a separate booster or partial switching converter is used, which includes the use of two IGBTs to eliminate all non-active power, ensuring that the unit, compressor, and IPM are provided with pure current. This has 2 to 3 benefits. The first benefit is that when all types of current are purified and the non-active current is removed, the second IPM will receive it. And what will happen then is that heat generation will be greatly reduced. The second benefit is that the sound produced will be significantly reduced. Normally, when we go near a unit, we don't hear any noise in the circuit. But internally, some sound is present, though it doesn't reach our ears. With this, the sound is further purified and reduced. Now, let's talk about the third benefit, which I consider the most important, and I believe that in the coming days, all companies will start converting to this and using it more frequently. The benefit is that sometimes the electricity in our homes is either too high or too low. So when this power switching converter is installed, it will control the unit well, whether the voltage and current are high or low, because it has two IGBTs installed, which can manage it effectively. Additionally, if the voltage is high or low, this PCB has a method to sense and control it more easily and sensitively. This will benefit the IPM and compressor, saving them from damage. If anything does go wrong, it will be the switching converter or something on the high side that will fail, but the rest of the unit will be saved. So, in this way, there are only benefits and no drawbacks. Friends, I want to make it clear that when high or low voltages occur, this device works even better, but it's important to understand that it doesn't produce any voltage or current, or either increase and decrease them. It only purifies the incoming electricity by removing non-active current, thus protecting the next system and reducing the chances of damage to the compressor. It also has sensitive ICs installed to detect high or low voltages and immediately shut down the entire PCB, saving your system, because when this circuit board shuts down and this PTC sensor overheats, the rest of the system is saved. Only the issue can arise on the high side. The low side will remain completely safe, which means the chances of repair are 100%, and your unit will be repaired quickly and at a lower cost. So you can take advantage of this. This is an excellent technology with many benefits, and it will be widely used in the coming days. Click on the left or right thumbnail to watch our next videos, and subscribe. Thank you.